Steel and scrap. Two industries that go hand in hand. They are often overlooked when it comes to model railroading or thought of as too big for their layout. But in this video, I'm going to show you some amazing footage and how you can easily incorporate it into your layout. Hey, this is DJ from DJ's Trains on YouTube, and I traveled to Youngstown, Ohio to bring you a unique look at Valurec. I think I pronounced that right. Now, this was once known as Youngstown Sheet and Tube, but today it is a busy pipe manufacturer, which you can model. Now, normally, when you think of steel, you think of the big blast furnaces that require iron ore and coke and lime to make molten iron, which then gets transferred into bottle cars to a basic oxygen furnace where it is mixed with scrap to make steel. Well, for this video, I'm going to make your life a lot easier, and I'm going to show you a different modeling approach. Any rail cars or engines or extra parts that you have laying around can make up part of your scrap yard. The metals get sorted and chopped up more and then put into gondolas. Now these gondolas travel to your mill where it gets unloaded and melted into steel once again. From there, it is rolled into pipe and sent back out in gondolas. It's pretty simple, but it's pretty fun to model. You can also use steel billets and have that melted down to make pipe also. So let's look at some inspiring views first of a scrapyard for some things that you can incorporate. Now here in Youngstown, we see a westbound CSX train. But on our right, we are at Midwest Steel and Alloy. Now this place has been around for such a long time. I would assume some of these cars are waiting to be scrapped. But what I'm going to do is I'm just going to zoom in on a couple areas that I think might help you with your modeling, give you some ideas, some things you probably have not thought about. So the first one, we look at this building, and what type of building do you think this is? My guess is that is a scale track. So here they are going to weigh the empty cars as they come in and then weigh them again when they're loaded and headed out. That way they know how much material was sent to the steel mill. Now this is a pretty big place. I didn't go all the way down. I just wanted to show you some things I thought were interesting. All the buildings pretty much look like what you can find by Pike stuff. They're pretty easy to build. So I had mentioned earlier about anything can be scrapped. And if you see some CSX noses right there, yes, there was even an Amtrak one. You might have to go back and watch that one. But here we're going to look at some switcher engines. Now these are personally my favorite engines to rail fan. But in 2022, I'm not even sure if these guys are running. And here we see the cab of a couple departed engines. Sad, I know. So then look behind those engines. That is a chassis system boxcar. So having that older rolling stock, some used for storage because that's chopped up a little bit. Bunch of tires, some things that cannot be recycled. They're just going to put into different piles. There's going to be a lot of guys that are going to be using the blow torches. And of course, you're going to have the gas for the blow torches. So you'll see a lot of tanks around here. Come back the other way. Now, because Youngstown is known for steel, you're going to see a lot of the scrap has something to do with the steel mill industry. From the hoods of the coil gons, if you look by those cranes, you will see rollers from rolling mills. Now, returning back to the mill, if your layout has a section that is long and narrow, this is a perfect opportunity to model something like this. You just make a photo backdrop, and then you can make the mill buildings like half the width. It really doesn't matter how wide all this stuff is. No one really cares. You just want to have the feel of the mill, followed by some tracks. I think there's four tracks here, and then your scrap yard between those tracks in the front of your layout. Keep it simple. This is a very simple thing you can do. Now, I'm going to show you something from a railroader's point of view. The Ohio Central works this area. Now, they're going to keep their engines here by that Ohio Central caboose. And look on the tracks. That black drop cloth is because when engines are stored, and they're usually fueled in a location like this, they have to be fueled over these black, we'll call them drop cloths. That way, for some reason, something spills, you have the drop cloths there. Also, look in the background. Those are red Pittsburgh and Lake Erie boxcars, which I thought was really interesting to see that in 2022. So having a designated set of power to service the steel mill is a great idea. So here's a really cool shot to show the track arrangement. Look at the crossovers. You can get pretty much from any track to any track. There's a track that's going to go into the building. Now, I like this shot also to show you all the different kinds of pipe that is being stored. So many different colors, different sizes, different varieties. It really gives you the opportunity to make things look more realistic when you see a shot like this. Like, okay, wow, not what I was expecting with some of the colors. There's going to be a mix of like 100-year-old buildings with some like newer cars and trucks and trailers. Now, a lot of times when industries have like really dirt roads, they will have a company come by with a water truck and spray the roads down because of so much dust gets kicked up. So if you see a lot of wet roads on a dry, hot day, that's the reason why. Now look inside the gondolas. Even though the gondolas are, quote, empty, they're not. They're going to have wood, and that wood is for moving pipe. You don't want that pipe getting scratched up on the bottom of a gondola that may have had rust in it earlier. So they're going to put wood down. It's going to help also with the bracing. They can put it on the sides of the cars to keep the pipe from moving. So yes, even though cars are empty, they're not. They're going to have wood in them. The buildings aren't just metal. If you look closely, you'll see brick buildings too. So hopefully this video gave you a lot of modeling ideas, no matter if you're doing N scale or HO or O scale. I have a whole playlist of steel mill modeling, a whole playlist. So after this video, go to my channel and you can check out the steel mill playlist. And actually look back here before we end this video. There is another little industry with the covered hoppers, and I got a big computer screen. I can tell you there's like a little track mobile or something that moves those cars. So, yeah, I was a little sad I didn't catch any Ohio Central engines this day, maybe make another trip soon. But I ask you to subscribe to my channel, DJ's Trains, and you can follow me on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram under DJ's Trains. Hundreds of videos teach you how the railroad works and how to model it. You can also check out my website, djstrains.com. And my Patreon site. Now, the Patreon site is great. It gives you a chance to support this channel, a chance for us to interact one-on-one with things like Zoom calls. There's a lot of perks to it, so check that out. Now, speaking of Patreons, I want to introduce you to my newest ones, Thomas Woodward and Tom Easley and Grant Hales and Mini Prince. And on my trip to Canada, I plan on seeing Mini Prince, and I'm going to show you some outstanding stuff that you haven't seen before. You're going to love it. So I have so much footage. There's more videos coming soon. I promise you're going to love the next bunch of videos. So subscribe if you haven't. Definitely should be subscribed. Killing it.